The Philippine Commission on Audit flags the Presidential Commission on Good Government, the agency tasked to recover the ill-gotten wealth of former strongman Ferdinand Marcos for failing to record dozens of stock certificates and artworks either recovered or surrendered to the agency. According to the COA's 2021 annual audit report, over 54 million pesos worth of stocks remain unlisted, and 122 artworks, including paintings and statues, have yet to be recorded in the books of the PCGG. The audit team notes the non-recording of these assets is tantamount to giving away possession of what is due to the government. It advised that the PCGG management to review the shares of active stocks for possible collection of dividends. The PCGG agrees to institute measures to monitor the stocks, while the agency will also conduct another inventory and reappraisal of the artworks.
The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board clarifies the 1 peso fare hike for jeepneys is temporary. It will be removed if oil prices go down to the 40 to 50 peso per liter level. Transport groups welcomed the fare hike, which brought the base fare for jeepneys operating in Metro Manila and Regions 3 and 4 to 10 pesos. But they say it's still not enough and government must look for ways to bring down oil prices.
Kapag ikaw ay nakapag laman ng pasahero sa loob ng isang araw na 300 passenger, eh malaking tulong po yung 300 pesos. Panduktong po doon sa bibili naming petroleum product doon sa mga station na kinakailangan po naming kargahan. Pangalawa, kung sapat po ba itong dinagdag na ito, hindi po ito talaga sapat.
For a commuters group, a fare hike of up to 2 pesos is still acceptable.
Handa po kaming makiambag sa ating mga transport sector sapagkat sa huling bilang po, kami na mga commuters at transport sector ang natitira sa lansangan. Oh. Sapat kami po ay magka-partner dyan. Hindi po namin sila pwedeng talikuran.
Tama.
At lalong-lalo na po ngayon ang nagkaroon ng approval na at least may taas na kaunti ng
piso.
Daily wage ng ating mga commuters.
Yun, daily wage.
Yung pong piso o dalawang piso ay maluwag po naming iaabot dun sa ating mga jeepney drivers, sa ating mga public utility vehicles.
A new executive order by Philippine President Duterte allows the government to tap the controversial multi-billion peso coconut fund. Duterte's order aims to modernize the country's coconut industry. But Sherian Torres tells us concerns have been raised over how the funds will be spent.
From 1971 to 1982, the regime of deposed President Ferdinand Marcos collected taxes and other forms of charges to coconut farmers selling copra. The cocoa levy was supposed to help modernize the industry and lift farmers out of poverty. But for 50 years since these taxes were collected, coconut farmers did not benefit from these funds, which according to a report from the Commission on Audit, now stands at 111.3 billion pesos. But these all changed after outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte signed Executive Order 172, or the Coconut Farmers and Industry Development Plan. EO 172 orders the introduction of new programs aided by better technologies to revitalize the country's coconut industry. It also aims to provide protection to coconut farmers and their family through the creation of the Coconut Farmers Organization, and seeks to promote stronger production and a wider market for coconut produce in the country. The Philippine Coconut Authority, along with some other agencies, will oversee the CFIDP, subject to a yearly evaluation. The fund will be sourced from cocoa levy assets. Mr. Duterte says these will achieve the twin objectives of rehabilitating and modernizing the coconut industry to attain social equity. Antonio Jesus Orbida, an official of a coconut farmers group in Negros Occidental, says the government should prioritize planting of new coconut trees to replace aging trees that are now 30 to 50 years old. Orbida adds a mechanization program is also needed to improve the production of other byproducts like the cocoa sugar and virgin coconut oil.
Naiwan tayo sa teknolohiya.
napabayaan po natin yung improvement ng ating teknolohiya.
However, opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros points out coconut farmers were not given a seat on the table. Ontiveros argues those who should benefit from the funds do not have a voice in the Trust Fund Committee. An official of the coconut industry reform movement raises the same issue.
One of the misgivings we have on this law is that government has sole responsibility of managing the funds. Mm. And that the sector, not even a representative of the coconut farming sector, would be allowed to have a look into how the funds are managed.
Faustino also asks why government agencies like the Department of Public Works and Highways can dip their fingers in the cocoa levy funds.
This law that passed, RA 11524, actually distributed the funds to around 16 agencies, including DPWH. So now DPWH can use part of the coconut levy fund that was recovered as ill-gotten wealth. Mm. They can now use this to build roads. But I was always questioning this because building roads is part of a government obligation. Correct. And you should not charge the coconut farmers for that.
The group is appealing to the incoming administration to first sit down with coconut farmers before formally allowing government agencies to decide on the fate of their industry. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.